In this video, I am going to talk about how to do the footings of a column. Okay, in this video you can see in the first picture, and this is the completed picture. We are going to construct 8 footings here. This is the footings and this is stud columns. First we have to do the excavation, and you can see in the edges we have done the excavation, because if we cut from here it is wastage, because we have to give more workforce for that, and the excavator charges and diesels and everything is there. Therefore when we are in the construction, if we have to do the excavation, we have to minimize the excavated soil. Okay, that is good. Okay, you can see this is the footing size, therefore we get the excavation from these edges. Think if the excavation, this is the top level of the soil, existing ground. So if the height, the existing ground to bottom of the footing height is 1200, you can just measure from this distance from your steel tape, then you can cut this area. If, because when we are cutting from the excavator, we can't level the all the things here, no. Therefore after completion the excavation, if the this is the footing area, you can install the level machine here and you can just level that and put the screed concrete or 1000 gauge polythene. What is the advantage that we have to put the screed concrete or 1000 gauge polythene? Because we have to prevent the water absorption from the soil. When you are putting concrete here, if the 1000 gauge polythene or screed concrete is near, the water is absorbed from this soil, then there can be some honeycombs in this footings. Okay, and other thing is, do the setting down. If the size of this footing is 1200, if you can make 1250 screed concrete here, you can do the setting out nicely here, and that is other advantage of doing the screed concrete. You can use 2x2, just put that, and if you want to level this, as I mentioned earlier, you can level this area using your level machine. Okay, and after that, after the screed concrete is done, you can do the setting out. If the this line and this line, just if you can put the center of the this screed concrete, you can do the your formwork from on this screed concrete. Okay, this is the reinforcement arrangement, and if you can look at that and have an idea what we have done here. And other things, I am not like that. If you can do the support from GI pipe, it's good, because there can be, you know, here we have used some 2x2, because there can be happen some buckling here. Therefore if you can put 2 GI pipes here and other 3 vertical bars, I think it's good. Okay, and therefore there can be happen buckling due to this load. Okay, so in the center, these are the centers of these columns, and you can see from here it is nicely here. You see, this is the lines, these are the lines. Okay, then here you can see here. Okay, these are the center lines from this side, and other side these are the two center lines. Okay, then from plumbet or whatever, you can find the centers of here, and you can do the setting out from here. And other thing is, you have to do the best supports, because when it's loading, if this is fail, this total concrete going out, okay, then you have to make sure the supports are good, okay. And you can see here goes the after concreting, okay. When you are concreting, there are some supports, because when we support like this, it's not going somewhere, no, okay, it's not changing. Therefore you have to think about safety and other everything. And you can see here, these are the formworks, because if we do the excavation closely to this edge, actually we don't want to pay for this area formwork, because you have to only do the three sides of the formwork, okay. Then we can save money. Likewise, therefore, if you are going to do some excavation from for whatever, don't do the big excavation, okay. Don't do that, okay. Only what are the requirement, do the excavation, okay. Now you have, I think you have, this is the picture after we have done, okay. You see here we do the footings, then we have to put the this you know, here setting out, here setting out for the column, and you can see how to support the columns, okay. Then first we have to split concrete, then the 14 with the net like this, then we have to do the concrete for this 40. Finally we have to make the formwork for the stud columns, okay. I think you have idea about these formworks and those things. If you have any problem about these things that I have mentioned here, put a comment, okay. I will reply you as soon as possible. Thank you very much.